Now, to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Waterloo winning Eurovision, this is ABBA at the BBC.
Hello, this is ABBA, and I'm Benny.
And I'm Agnetha.
And I'm Frida.
And I'm Bjorn. You know, it's really great to be here at the BBC studios doing our own star special. We're going to be DJs, all of us, and I'll start off. You know, I haven't been much of a dancer before. Maybe because there hasn't been a lot of music to dance to. Our own star special. We're going to be DJs, all of us, and I'll start off. You know, I haven't been much of a dancer before. Maybe because there hasn't been a lot of music to dance to. But during the last 2 years, I've really started and I enjoy it enormously.
I know your initials individually are ABBA, which spells ABBA, but whose bright idea was it to call you ABBA?
I'd say it was Stig's memos, you know, when he was to tell the people at the office what to do with us, and instead of writing all the names, just making it short.
Kind of abbreviation.
You know? Yeah. But there was DJs at the same time started using it too.
They got crazy calling us Benny, Bjorn, Agnetha.
As long as you behave.
They also send us some
hearing
cans.
Kind of up to here in cold fish, yeah.
Tuna fish.
Tends to Waterloo, the song that won last Saturday's Eurovision Song Contest by a mile. Sung by the Swedish group ABBA, Waterloo looks like being a really big seller and making a chart entry from nowhere next week. But if you were one of the 500 million Eurovision viewers, you may be wondering which was more important in getting the song through to number one. Was it the music or the way out gear? Well, who better to ask than Anna, the girl with the tight pants herself and husband Jorn?
Well, I think it is always good with glitter. I mean, other people notice us.
Where did the clothes come from?
We knew a Finnish girl in Sweden that went to London and did it for us. We like the style.
They're thoroughly international clothes, then. Finnish girl making them in London,
yes,
for a Swedish group.
Really, yeah.
What plans have you got ahead of you now?
Is we doing Top of the Pops and...
rolling in now that...
is there? That's nice.
Yes, yeah. Really.
What would you like to do with it now that perhaps things are coming in internationally for you? What about conquering more foreign markets?
I mean, yes, yes.
Swedish pop takes over Europe?
I'm afraid not, no.
Why not?
I mean, you got 60 million people here, we have 8. So obviously you got a lot more to take from. And you got a sort of pop tradition, which we don't.
That's you. I got
very busy with the new album and also with the film, the movie that we made. The whole film is completely Lasse Hallström's idea, the director and also the writer.
This jockey, who's is a specialist in country and western, and he gets this assignment to get an in-depth interview with us. And he goes through all kinds of funny situations.
So if you want a song from the film, I think you should take Eagle to start with, because it has really come out very, very good on the film. And I also think it's a good track from the album.
It was beautifully set up, wasn't it, Dean?
There was such a big kick in writing Take a Chance on Me. We came up with that little...
We did, it all comes down to love. Do I have it in me?
Celebrating the 50th anniversary of ABBA's Eurovision win with Waterloo. And if you want to hear more programmes from this season, including our ABBA Eras podcast, just search ABBA.